Dear students, today we are going to see translation. Let us first see the definition of translation. Translation is the process wherein the messenger RNA is read by the ribosome and is translated to form protein. Translated to form a protein. So if mRNA information, whatever the information there in the mRNA is converted into a full-fledged protein with the help of these tRNAs and ribosomes, then that process is said to be translation. And now let us see what are the required molecules, that are macromolecules that are required for this process to occur. The first one is going to be, we need mRNA. The second one is, we need amino acids. We need ribosome. We need tRNA molecules. All these four are required for the process called translation. So let us first see one by one the mRNA. We have already discussed regarding mRNA in the video prepared on genetic code. So what is it, what about it? mRNA is a single stranded the three nucleotides are grouped into a codon. Likewise, we have seen each codon represents an amino acid. That is what we have studied in the genetic code video. Next, we are going to see now the tRNA molecule. So tRNA, also known as transfer RNA. This transfer RNA are nothing but these acts as molecular bridges that connect mRNA codons to the amino acids that they encode. And another point. One end of the each tRNA has a sequence of three nucleotides called anticodon. Please do remember that three codons that are present in mRNA are called codon, whereas three nucleotides that present one end of the tRNA are called anticodon. This anticodons bind with the mRNA codons. We will see that one later. So next, let us observe this structure. Let us observe the structure of tRNA molecule that was pasted here at the right hand side, bottom. And here you could see in tRNA structure, the green colored portion, this is the green colored portion, indicates a tRNA. And if you observe the one end of this green color structure at the top, you could see it carries an amino acid. Haven't you seen that one, what they written? LVU. LVU means leucine. So this particular tRNA carrying at its 3' LVU amino acid, that is leucine amino acid. When you observe the other end, that is here, the another end of this green colored structure, it has a three nucleotides. These three nucleotides are called anticodons. These three nucleotides are anticodons. You could also observe that these three nucleotides are now base pairing with the, what is that one, mRNA at the bottom. Now there are different tRNAs, different types of tRNAs are there. Each type reads one or a few codons and brings the right amino acid matching those codons. So with that, we have seen what is that one, transfer RNA. And let us move on to the another slide. So here you could see in a bigger manner, I have pasted a
nice diagram here. You could see this one, the large balloon type structure. This is called ribosome. And you could see within this ribosome, has two subunits. That means it is made up of two parts. One is a larger subunit, the another one is called smaller subunit. And this particular ribosome have, you know, A site, P site and E site. And you could see here the mRNA, the rod like structure. Haven't you seen that one? The that starts from 5', that ends it to 3'. That is what is called mRNA. And mRNA, see this one, the codons, the group of three nucleotides called codon, and it is codons. And what happened? This is what we are studying so far. This is nothing but tRNA. At one end, you could see at one end of this tRNA, it is carrying an amino acid. Here it is TRP. TRP means tryptophan. Another end, you could also see here at the another end, anticodon is present. So we should remember that codons are present where? Codons are present in mRNA, whereas anticodons are present where? Anticodons are present in tRNA molecule. These, with the help of this anticodons, they come and bind. Have you seen this one? This tRNA, the mark is also indicating the tRNAs are coming and binding within the ribosome at a particular place. I will explain all those things in the later on mRNA, where specific codons are present. So codon, anticodon should be complementary to each other. Then only the tRNA binds on the codon, isn't it? So we'll see the next one. The next one is going to be, next slide is going to be ribosomes. That is what we are discussing so far. What are ribosomes? Ribosomes are the structures where proteins are built. So ribosomes are, we could say that ribosomes are factories that build proteins. They are made up of, so they made proteins, and but they are made up of, ribosomes are made up of some proteins, and this is very important one. Ribosomal RNA are also known as rRNA. They are nothing but mixture of rRNA and proteins. They are made up of, but they make other proteins. That is important thing, you should not confuse there. So another thing, each ribosome has two subunits. That is what we have seen. This is the larger one and this is the smaller one. Larger one and smaller one, which come together, this is important, which come together around mRNA. So this is mRNA. Around this mRNA, the larger and smaller subunits are connected together, a kind of the two halves of the hamburger bun coming together around the patty. So now ribosome provides a set of handy slots. So handy slots, that is what we have seen. So ribosomes has three slots. What are those slots? A, P and E. You should remember three slots. Ribosomes provide three slots. A means arrival, P means peptidyl activity site, E means exit site. These sites where tRNAs can find their matching codons, very important. These are the sites where tRNAs can find their matching codons on mRNA template, very important thing, and deliver their amino acids here. These slots are called A, P and E. A means arrival, P means peptidyl transferase activity, generally it has, that is peptidyl site, and E means exit sites. And not only but the ribosomes also act as an enzyme. It also acts as an enzyme, catalyzing the chemical reaction that links amino acid together to make a chain. That is another thing. Whatever I told, the P site, peptidyl site, the peptidyl site where this amino acid binding activity. That means one amino acid bind with another amino acid. What is the link is there between two amino acids? That is peptide bond. So peptide bonds between two amino acids are formed here in the P site. So we will see that one later. So this is the thing. So regarding ribosome, what we have seen ribosomes are factories where proteins are made. And second thing, ribosomes are made up of some proteins and rRNAs. Ribosomes have two subunits. One is larger, one is smaller. They come together around mRNA so that the tRNAs come and bind at the three that are provided by the ribosome. That is what we have seen. The sites are called as A site, arrival site, P peptidyl transferase site, E means exit site. That is what we have seen so far, isn't it? That is all that about ribosomes. And now let us move on to the another site. Another one is a very important thing. We are going to see the steps of what is called translation. In the steps of translation, what are the steps? In the transcription also we have seen three stages. As usual, here also in translation also, there are three steps. One is called initiation and elongation, and the last one is termination. Initiation, elongation, termination. These are the three steps that are present in the translation. These are the steps of translation. So another important thing, every cell in our body, I already been told that we, a human body, is made up of more than 10 to the power of 10 cells, and each and every cell in every second they are in the process of making new proteins. They are always involved in the process of translation every day, every second. So, and each of these proteins must contain right set of amino acids. That is very important thing. If a protein does not have a specific set of amino acids, simply we used to have several problems, health problems. So that is why each and every protein that is produced inside our body should be in a right combination. So and only the right set of amino acids are linked together by the translation process. And we already said that this translation process is of three types. One is initiation, the second one is elongation, and another one is termination. Let us move on to the another slide, that is initiation. Just we are talking about the three steps of translation. The first one, that is initiation. In initiation, the ribosomes assembles around mRNA. So what we have seen in the previous slides, ribosomes have two subunits, one the larger one and the smaller one. What he is telling is, so the larger and smaller subunits, these are the larger one, this is the smaller one, these are assembled around the mRNA and read the first tRNA and the first tRNA carrying amino acid methionine. Very important thing I should tell here. If a tRNA carrying an amino acid, that tRNA is said to be aminoacyl tRNA. You got my point? If a tRNA carries any amino acid, that tRNA is said to be aminoacyl tRNA. In general, what we have learned in the previous videos in the transcription, we have seen that the first codon in every mRNA is AUG, that codes for methionine. He is also telling the same. The first tRNA carrying the amino acid methionine and come and bind at a particular site here. This setup is called initiation complex. What is the initiation complex? the assembly of larger subunit and smaller subunit around the mRNA, and the initiate, the first tRNA comes with methionine amino acid and binds the site, form this whole process is said to be initiation process. And this, whatever the complex all together, that is tRNA, ribosome, mRNA, all this is forms a complex. This complex is called as initiation complex. You got my point? And next, let us see the another side, what is there in it. In the next slide, we could see the elongation. In elongation process, in elongation is the stage where the amino acid chain gets longer. That means in the initiation, what we have seen, only a single tRNA brought come up with one amino acid, but a protein has thousands of amino acids. One amino acid won't be sufficient. These ribosomes are factories for making the proteins. That is why number of tRNAs will come and donates the amino acids, and the amino acid link together, and the chain, the polypeptide chain, get bigger. So this process, the process of amino acid chain gets longer, is called as elongation process. Okay, first we will see that elongation process with a nice diagram. Later we will discuss in this diagram you could see after initiation this entire three diagrams represents what is called elongation process. Now what happened at the first, no need to tell again and again, this is the larger subunit, this is the smaller subunit of ribosome, and methionine is the first amino acid that comes and bind at the P site. That is what you should remember, P site. First one, always amino acid binds at the P site. On where? On the mRNA. Next, the second tRNA also come and bind the another site of the ribosome. What is that site is called? A site. So APE, arrival site, peptidyl transferase site, and exit site. Three sites are there, APE. So first amino acid occupies P site, second amino acid occupies at the A site. So first amino acid and second amino acid. The case here is the first amino acid methionine and the second amino acid is what? SER. SER means serine. The second amino acid is serine. So next, in the elongation, what happened? In the elongation, the step is going to be peptide bond formation. What is the meaning of the word peptide bond formation? Peptide bond, two amino acids are joined together by a bond called peptide bond. Here we have two amino acids here in this picture. One is methionine and another one is serine. So these two amino acids are linked together. Where they linked together? See, the first amino acid methionine releases from its tRNA and bonded with the serine. That serine is on the site A with its tRNA. So peptide bond is formed between methionine and serine. This is the step happened here. And another one. Once this one is happened, now what happened? This is very important. The process is called translocation. What is the meaning of the word translocation? Translocation, that is movement, changing of the place. Translocation. Who is going to change its place? The ribosome. The ribosome changes its place. That means the ribosome moves on where? On mRNA. So the ribosome moves on the mRNA in this direction. When it moves, ribosomes, always a ribosome moves at a time three nucleotides length. Always moves three nucleotide lengths. Now what happened when this ribosomes moves further? What happened? The methionine tRNA comes into E site. This is the one. And the serine tRNA comes into the P site. And now the A site is vacant. Now what will happen? Whatever the tRNA that is present at the E site just leaves from that site, exit. E for exit. Exit means that tRNA release it from that site. Okay, that is released from that site. And next, what will happen? Next, A means arrival site. One tRNA carrying an amino acid come and occupies here. So another one mRNA will come and occupies this site. Then what happened? The methionine and the serine, these two bound with some another amino acid here. And next what happened? Next, translocation takes place. Three nucleotides, a gap of three nucleotides is moved by the ribosome. This is called translocation. And whatever the amino acid, whatever the tRNA that is present in the E site will be exit, and another new tRNA will occupy at the A site. Are you getting it? So this is a cycle. This is step one, this is step one, this is step two, and this is step three. Again, what happened? Once after third step, first step is repeating, then second step, then third step, then first step. This is a loop. This process is called as elongation. We will see that elongation, initiation, elongation, termination by an animation picture. We will see that one at the end of this lecture. And let us move on to the another slide. The last step is going to be termination. Now, what is termination? Termination is the stage in which the finished polypeptide chain is released. Terminate. That means once all the amino acids of a protein are added, then there is no need to wait for another amino acid. Then simply the protein synthesis terminates. So this termination is brought about by some specific codons called stop codons. We already seen that one in the genetic code table. What is those stop codons? One is UGA, UAA, UAG. These are the three codons that are called as stop codons. They do not code any amino acid. That is why there is no specific tRNA there to bring any amino acid. That is what automatically the translation process will come to a grinding halt. And this process is called what? Termination. After termination, what will happen after termination? Whatever the components of the termination process, like tRNAs, tRNAs, mRNA, ribosomes, all these components, amino acids, all these components released from the site. They become, now they detach it from the site at the end of the termination. So after this termination process, we have seen what are the protein that is released, that is coming out of the translation, is in primary structure. The primary structure converted into we already know that protein has different structures, like primary, secondary. The structural levels are there: primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary. According to the protein nature, it is folded and form a three-dimensional shape, and it undergoes some processing steps.
In this video or animation, you will able to see central dogma of molecular biology, where DNA is converted into mRNA, mRNA is to protein. So here our ribosome is there, having three sites: E site, P site, and A site, and with two subunits. mRNA is at the middle, and one amino acid tRNA, which carries amino acid, bind at the P site. The second amino acid tRNA occupies at the A site. Then what happened? See, whatever the blinking over there is called anticodon, and now it is the blinking one is codon. When anticodon codon matches, then only tRNA binds at the mRNA. Now what happened? Ribosome translocation takes place. These two tRNAs moves into E site and P site, and the amino acid on the last amino acid transferred to the P site tRNA, and E site tRNA exits, and then a new tRNA with amino acids comes and occupies at the site A. Now the P site tRNA's amino acids are transferred to A site, and this process continues. Just observe the process for a while, so that you people could easily understand what is happening. You observe at the top what is happening. The beads are attaching one to another. It is nothing but protein. So now a termination is happening over there.